Hey there and welcome. My name is Mr. Barry. Today I'm going to show you how to find your CPU as well as your RAM information right on your Chromebook. Now in the past what I've done is I've actually made videos on how to find all this information. However, when I give you the address to find that information, such as what we see here on that video link, basically it gives you all of the system information. I mean, it tells you like 10 pages worth of information, and versus just the CPU, it might give you like 3 or 4 pages for just the CPU. And people are saying, well, that's too much information. All we need is the model number, maybe its speed, and the amount of gigabytes in my RAM, and that's it, nothing else. So guess what? I went to work and I found a nice extension that you can install. So I'm gonna show you how to install this extension, how to use it and find that CPU as well as that RAM information that you've been wanting to find out. And then I'm going to show you how to remove that extension, because you really, after you know that information, you don't need that extension running off in the background of your Chromebook. So let me show you how to do that right now. Here I am in my Chromebook. Now the very first thing that you want to do is click on the app launcher found in the lower corner there. And it comes up, and then you want to click on the Chrome Web Store. Click it, and it opens up as we see here. Now, once you're in the Chrome Web Store, click on the search box and key in System Info. And it comes up, hit the Enter key. And now, the very first one there that we see is by Dave Christian. Click it, and it expands into this window. Notice in the center here, it gives you a little preview of what to expect. So it will show you the CPU model number, as well as the amount of RAM that you have in there. So if you did have a Core i3, Core i5, you'll actually show that. But most people have a type of Celeron processor, and it'll show that as well with the N numbers. Now here's some examples of some processors that you might find in your Chromebook, such as the N4000, or the N5000, or the N6000 there. Now, the very first number that you see there is the generation number. So if it's a 4, it's the 4th generation of the Intel processors. The 5 there represents the 5th generation. And the N there is for notebook. So it's a type of processor that consumes less power and allow you to have a longer lasting battery. Again, these are not Core i3, Core i5 processors. These are Celeron processors, but they are made by Intel. Now that you know what that means, let's go on to the next step. Click on Add to Chrome, and then add as I've done there, and it adds it to your Chrome. Now we have it up there at the very top. Go ahead and click on the icon that's been added up there, and whoa, there's the information. Now you can see there from that information that I have a Celeron N4200 processor running at 1.1 gigahertz. And that's actually fast enough to create the videos that you see here. And I also play World of Tanks on my Chromebook. So this is what World of Tanks looks like. And as you can see, the graphics is really highly detailed. I actually have a separate video there showing you how to actually get that onto your Chromebook so that you can play World of Tanks with your friends as well. And it's really a lot of fun for me anyway. So yes, I do play World of Tanks on my Chromebook as well as other things, so it's not a slow processor. Below that, you see I have 4 gigs of RAM on my Chromebook. Now, once you have that information and you're done with it, you've written it down, you want to remove it, right? Well, to do that, just click on the puzzle piece, and then you have all of your extensions shown there. Find that extension there that says System Information, click on the 3 dots, and then click on Remove from Chrome. From there, what you're going to need to do is click on Remove, and it removes it from your Chrome extensions. Boom, it's gone. Now what I want to do is I want to show you another way to find other system information, just in case you wanted to find everything about your Chromebook. Up there in the URL address box, what you'll need to do is type in Chrome, and then the :// system, as I've done there, and I'll have a link here as well as in the description so that you can find it very easily. And once you've keyed that in there, it'll open up and you have basically all of the system information here. Now, there's, like I said earlier in the video, there's like 5 or 10 pages worth of information just right here. If you go down a little bit, it'll say system or CPU info, and then click on the button that says expand, and it shows you more information about your CPU. Again, it shows you everything about your CPU, but just in case you want to know everything, there it is. And it will show you the model number, as well as the speed that it's running and all the other information about your CPU. And if you weren't sure what that model number is, you can actually go ahead and copy it and then do a Google search, and it'll show you more information about that type of model number for the processor that you have. Anyway, that's how you find your CPU and RAM information on your Chromebook. So I've shown you two ways to do that. One is with that easy to use extension. Another way is by using the built-in system info that's on your Chromebook. Hey, if you like these types of videos, please give it a thumbs up, because I really appreciate that and it really helps the channel. Comment down below, because I love to read your comments. And if you have a question or, you know, a suggestion, leave those down in the comments, and I'll be happy to get to those as soon as I can. And also, if you haven't done so already, please subscribe to my channel and share the video. Anyway, thank you very much for watching the video, and have a wonderful day. Bye-bye.